Hello friends, today we will solve a problem on a square prism with a freely suspended statement. So this is the problem number 13 in your CAD drawing solution book in the page number 89. Okay, we'll go through the computer sketching. See here, in this problem, whenever they are given the statement like the object is suspended freely from one of its corner, so we need to make some assumptions. In the very first step, we need to construct the object with the corner position. So construct the square object in the top view. Select continuous line 0.5 millimeter. We'll select the width of 35 millimeter, the given, and the height is 35 millimeter. And for the corner position, we need to specify the angle of 45 degree. Then you can place the object just below the XY line. In the next step, select line command, continuous line 0.13 millimeter thickness. From the each endpoint, just draw one vertical thin projection line. Again, from the rightmost endpoint, draw a line. For the front view, they given the axis length 60 millimeter in the problem statement. So we'll project, we'll change the line thickness, make it 0.5 millimeter. Length is 60 millimeter. Angle is 90. Again, move the cursor over here, we are getting a dotted line. So exactly for the same plane, draw a line and project it downward. So again for the right side. Similarly, at the center, draw a thin continuous line. From the front view, these three lines are visible. So the visible edges should be represented by a thick continuous line. In the next step, we need to represent notations, but so normally we are taking a right side corner as a reference in case of solid problems. So we'll start giving a notation A of A1, B of B1, C of C1 and D of D1. Similarly in the front view, A1 dash and A dash, okay, like that. In the next step, it is very essential to mention the dimension both in front and top views. Okay, for the next step, they can give a statement like the object is suspended freely from a corner of its base. So we'll draw a thin reference line. Draw a vertical thin reference line up to the XY line. In the next step, so we need to find the value of CG, center of gravity. For that we have a formula for prism, axis length by 2. That means we are getting a center of gravity exactly at the midpoint of this center line. So go to tools, select Intel sketch, relationship, select midpoint and OK. Then select line command, continuous line 0.13 millimeter thickness. So from the lowermost endpoint of this B1 dash of D1 dash, move the cursor over here, and where exactly you're getting a midpoint symbol there, left click. From that midpoint, you can draw a thin projection line towards right side upper corner. Okay. In the next step, you can select text command and mention this step as the point G. So after finding the midpoint here, normally we need to put a formula for center of gravity, that is axis length by 2. So we are getting a center of gravity here. In the next step, select this entire first position front view. Okay, then select move command. Switch on, move and copy, then you can select the rightmost top edges, okay, then you can keep it on this a vertical line, okay, anywhere on this vertical line, you just keep it and directly go and select rotate command, select the rightmost endpoint as a fixed point and the point G as a fixed point. Now we can rotate. In the meantime, we have to switch off this rotate and copy. So make sure that the point A and A dash and G lies in the same vertical line. So that's our objective. Whenever object is suspended freely, this uppermost corner and the point G should lie in the same vertical line. Just you can place it on the same line and left click. Okay? And in the meantime, make sure that the lowermost endpoint should not touch us XY line in case of freely suspended problem. For the top view, select line command, continuous line 0.13 millimeter thickness. From the each endpoint, draw a vertical thin projection line. That should be straight line. All projection lines should be either horizontal or vertical. Okay? So from the each endpoint, you can draw a vertical thin projection line. If you are not getting a straight line, specify the angle 0 degree for horizontal line. Similarly, from the point B of B1, now we can trim all these extra line and we can mention. Okay, in the next step, after drawing a projection line from the second position front view and the first position top view, we need to identify the invisible edges in case of second position top view. For that, see that whenever observer looking the object from the top view, so these lines are not visible. C1 to C and C1 to B1, C1 to D1 lines are invisible. So from the point C1, you can just draw a line of a thick dashed line. And also from the point C1 to D1, just draw. Okay? In the next step, so select continuous line. You can join the remaining edges by thick continuous line because all the edges are visible from the point A to B, B to C, C to D. If you are not getting intersection point, go to tool, Intel sketch, and then select midpoint. Okay, select this point D, C to D, and D to A. In the next step, it is very, very important to join these lateral edges. You have to join every endpoint A to A1, B to B1, C to C1, and D to D1. Okay? I hope A to A1 is missing here. You have to join that one. The next step, select line command, continuous line, 0.13 millimeter thickness. Okay? From the XY line, they draw a line. So in the problem statement, they're given that the axis appears to be and inclined to VP by an angle of 45 degree. So draw a line of 45 degree. So whenever they given the statement, axis appears to be, no need to find out bit angle for this freely suspended problem. Okay? So you can select this endpoint here and select this edge just to select move command, switch on move and copy. I will select this endpoint A1 and keep it on this 45 degree line. Now we can select rotate command, select the rightmost endpoint as a fixed point and the leftmost endpoint for rotation. You can exactly place the object on this a 45 degree line. Okay, then for the front view, select line command, continuous line, 0.13 millimeter thickness. From the uppermost endpoint here, draw a vertical thin projection line. Similarly, okay, so draw a line from each endpoint. From the B1 dash of D1 dash, draw one vertical thin projection line. So this is the endpoint B1. So draw a line. So you have to trim this extra line. The next step, from the point C1 dash, draw a horizontal thin line. Now from the point C, actually, don't forget to trim this extra line. In the next step, we need to give a notation. So this is the endpoint A dash here. Now, this one is B dash. And it is C dash. Then D dash. Okay, similarly, we are getting the endpoint A1 dash, B1 dash, B1 dash. Then C1 dash is the lowermost edges here and D1 dash. So then don't forget to draw center line. So now we need to identify the invisible edges in case of the front view. For that, select line command, dashed line, 0.5 millimeter thickness. So the endpoint D1 is nearer to the XY line. So from the point D1 dash to D dash is a thick dashed line. So now all the line passing from the point D1 dash is invisible. That is D1 dash to A1 dash, then D1 dash to C1 dash lines are invisible and all other remaining lines are visible. So I can join it by thick continuous line C1 dash to B1 dash, B1 dash to A1 dash, A1 dash to A dash, A dash to D dash, D dash to C dash, C dash to B dash, and B dash to A dash. In the next step, we need to join these lateral edges B dash to B1 dash so it is visible. Join it by a thick continuous line. Similarly, C1 dash to C dash, draw it by a thick continuous line. Okay? So that's about the projection of this square prism with a freely suspended statement. So at the end, don't forget to mention this angle and dimension. That's very, very important. Most of the time, 10% of the maximum marks will be deducted for the missing dimension and data. So that's it. Thank you. Thanks for watching. For more videos, you can subscribe to my channel. Thank you.